Hello and welcome to another Universe Lab video. Today I'm going to be telling you how to download and complete a set of Mars Top Trump cards that you can then print off and play with your friends. So to start with, click on the link in the description box down below or go to our website on screen now. Once you're there, you can find the Universe Lab activities and click on Surviving on Mars. Here you'll be able to download the Top Trump card set and watch our series of videos called Surviving on Mars. This series of videos will teach you everything you need to know about the conditions on the planet and what we need to consider before sending a human crew to set up base there. This is information that you'll need to complete your Top Trump set. Once you've downloaded the PDF, open it up in any PDF viewer. If you don't have a PDF viewer, I've added links to a couple of programs that I recommend in the description box. Once you've opened the document, you'll see something that looks like this. A set of 32 unique cards, and you can see the front and the back of each card. Each card represents a different region on Mars. So you'll see the name, a photograph, and a short description of each location. You'll also see a set of categories at the bottom of each card. To actually play a game of Top Trumps with these cards, you'll need to add a value for each of these categories. Players will compare these values for different cards to determine the winner, and the winner will be the higher number in this case. So, before we can play with our Top Trump cards, our task today is to add a value for each of these five categories on all of our cards. But we're not just going to add numbers at random. We want to make sure that the game is fair, but we also want to make sure that these values are accurate for each location so that we can learn a little bit about Mars as we play. The rules for assigning points are: each card gets 30 points total to distribute across the five values, and the maximum number of points a category can have is 10. So for example, you could keep it very simple and assign 10 points to three categories and 0 points to the other two. Or you can distribute them a bit more evenly. But again, we want to make sure that these values are as accurate as possible for each location. And to do this, we need to look at the categories in more detail. So let's start at the top with conditions. So this rates the conditions at each location, mostly focusing on temperature. So to determine what the conditions are like for each location, our biggest clue is where it is on Mars. And you can see this in the top right of the card. The yellow star shows where the region is on Mars, whether it's close to the poles or close to the equator. Just like on Earth, Mars is tilted on its axis, and this means that the equator receives more sunlight throughout the year than the regions closer to the poles, and this makes the equator the warmest place on the planet. Columbia Hills, my example card, is located very close to the equator, so I'm going to give it 8 points out of 10. As you can see, I can just type directly onto the card, and this makes it easy to alter later if I change my mind. So next up is safety. This is specifically looking at how safe it would be to land a spacecraft here. Landing is one of the most dangerous parts of a mission to Mars, and to minimize risk, we actually want to land on a flat, stable surface. You can find information about the surface features either on the photograph or in the descriptive text. As you can see, Columbia Hills has some sloping inclines, but overall it's quite flat. I'm going to give it 6 points out of 10. Next up is scientific interest, one of the main reasons we go to Mars. Information on this category will be found in the descriptive text, and it's up to you to decide whether it sounds like there is some interesting science to be done at this location. Columbia Hills is similar to areas on Earth where we find fossils, but there are definitely more interesting regions on Mars, so I'm going to give it 3 points out of 10. Next, we have resources. So this can include things like water, clay that can be used as building material, and sunlight for solar power. To help you with this one, look in the descriptive text and look at where the region is located on Mars. Columbia Hills is a great place for collecting solar energy, but that's about it. So I'll give it 5 points out of 10. Now, I have 7 points left for my final category. If that seems too little or too much, I can easily go back and alter my other values. So the final category is survival. This is a kind of summary of all of the other categories. Based on everything we've just looked at, we now want to rate whether this region would be a good place to build the first human base on Mars. Columbia Hills is warm, it receives a lot of solar energy for electricity, for growing crops, and for keeping people healthy. Plus, it's fairly flat, making it a safe place to land and build on. It may not be the most scientifically interesting, and we'd have to think carefully about how to provide water to the base, but I think 7 out of 10 sounds about right. And that's it. Do the same for all 32 cards, or you can get someone to help you, then print them off and you're ready to play. Enjoy your new set of Top Trump cards, and I'll see you next time.